Well, no Whitney Houston song today, or for the time being, until we ever go back to Allen Fieldhouse, which I, the way college basketball is, probably never, not my lifetime. But OU falls to Kansas 78-66. Solid first half for OU. Fell behind early, but fought back and only trailed by one at the break. But unfortunately, just didn't have that second half juice. McCollum had a solid game, 17 points. Away, I can never pronounce his name. 12 points for him. Uzon, 15 points. Bench only gave you 11 points, so you need really help from your bench, unfortunately. Some turnovers didn't go your way. Some shots didn't go down that you needed. And it's hard to win there because, whether the refs, favor Kansas or not, or however you want to put it, it's a little disappointing. I'm still on board with this Porter Moser team for the most part. You dropped your third game to this week, and I do really believe part of it was I do just the way things work. I think UCF kind of woke up Kansas a little bit earlier this week when they lost to UCF on the road. I'm like, oh, that's not what we needed right now. I was hoping they would come in a little overconfident and cocky, and then we'd catch them off guard. But alas, UCF just had to do that. But anyway, we'll see what happens the rest of the way. We're getting to mid-January at this point, so you want to try to finish strong. Big 12 is still tough. You still got teams like Houston you got to play at some point, so a lot to play for. This will be a tournament team, regardless how they do regular season or the Big 12 tournament. This team will make the tournament, and looking forward to watch more down the road. But in football news today, finally, it's official. Zach Alley is officially acknowledged by the school as the co-defensive coordinator and linebackers coach. Finally made official today. It was kind of like it's the worst kept secret. He was staying at Brent's house for a while. Just reading some quotes in the press release here, saying all the good things about him. Jacksonville State, he had a defensive unit ranked 33rd out of 133 teams. That's better than we've had in God knows how long. In scoring defense, 21.2 points, 43rd in total defense. And listen, I think the numbers are going to be there down the road. I think for Zach Alley, he's going to be able to put together, he's going to be able to do what Brent wants him to do. Ted Roof, I've called him a hand puppet for Brent, and I'll say the same thing for Zach Alley. And I don't mean that in a negative tone or a negative context. I think Zach Alley is exactly what Brent wants. And at the end of the day, I've mentioned this before, I want a younger guy out there on the road. No offense to Ted Roof and everything, but you want a younger guy, and he'll be able to hopefully relate to recruits a lot better. And the only question I have for him is because he just hasn't had a chance to do it yet. How is he going to be able to recruit at a big time program? He's been able to find those diamonds in the rough when he was at previous places, whether he's at Clemson helping out Brent, because that's where kind of like where the relationship started. He was Brent's right hand man. And of course, the defenses for Clemson were so much better than ours. And hopefully, he can not only just find those diamonds in the rough, but he can also be a way to, go get those guys, add more to the stockade, whether it's like helping guys on D line, defensive back, special linebacker. Linebacker, I think recruiting needs a little bit of a boost, a little bit of a shot in the arm, and hopefully he'll be able to add that to this team, to this roster down the road. But I'm not worried about the defensive side of the ball when it comes to recruiting at the moment. It's the other side of the ball, and I know everyone has their thoughts. I've shared my thoughts on how O-line recruiting is going, and it's only been a day or so, but it's got to find a way to find another diamond in the rough or two post spring ball in the transfer portal. That's what you're going to have to do. I know there's a lot of other pieces moving. Alabama's losing a bunch of guys because it's just the nature of the beast with the new coach there. I know there's some hope about getting some guys from Washington on the defensive side of the football potentially. Try to keep an eye on that, but nothing official yet. But you're just paying attention to who Brent is following on Twitter and whatnot, who the recruiting guys for OU are following on Twitter. It could be a pain in the ass, but thankfully there's a lot of other people doing it, so you can just play catch up fairly quickly. But again, I'm not making promises or saying who yet. It's just, you try to get excited about someone. You really thought Lance Hurd was going to be your guy. He's getting crystal balled in future forecast to Tennessee. So nothing official there yet, but you hope maybe there's a Hail Mary, but I'm not holding out hope for that. So yeah, OU comes up a little short tomorrow. You got some football games for the playoffs getting pushed back. The Buffalo Miami game getting pushed back. I'm sorry, no, the Buffalo Steelers game getting pushed back. I'm crossing up my teams here in the AFC. of the governor of New York's like, no, we're not playing football today. Too cold, too dangerous. So they're moving it to Monday. But Dallas will be very warm and toasty indoors when they play Green Bay tomorrow afternoon. And so we'll see how that one goes. But I'm looking forward to that one. I will have Hank Hill ready to go to post my all-time favorite clip from that show where he driving down the road singing the Dallas Cowboys fight song. So hopefully Dallas gets a big win and returns to the divisional round where they have faced their doom every single time since after Barry Switzer left. It's been that long since they've won a divisional playoff game and gone to the NFC Championship game. Let's win this one first. Let's beat Green Bay because there's the whole Green Bay has won in Dallas X amount of times in a row. I know. Believe me, I've seen most of them, if not all of them. So with that being said, Boomer Sooner. It sucks that we didn't came up a little short in Lawrence today, but we have a defensive coordinator now, so we're happy about that. And we'll keep I'll keep an eye on things going with recruiting for because we got 2025 is on the horizon, and we got to get ready to spend the whole year recruiting for that, and winter workouts, all those fun things, and just get ready for spring ball at some point. But until then, I'll catch y'all later, Boomer.